Club and was pulled over for driving 48 in a 35 mile per hour zone, according to the Tampa Bay Times. The SUV belonged to his father, who was actually pretty powerful, State Senator Don Gaetz. Now, he apparently refused to do a field sobriety test or a breathalyzer test. The deputy, identified as Chris Anglin, wrote in the arrest report that Gaetz had been unsteady on his feet and that his eyes were bloodshot. Gaetz reportedly admitted to having two beers and refused to perform a field sobriety test or take a breath test. So what happened to Gaetz? Did he have to pay the consequences for his actions since he was clearly driving under the influence? No, might have something to do with his state senator father. Gaetz was never convicted, and he was promoted and has promoted efforts to have mugshots removed from private websites.
Yeah. So. And the other irony here is Hunter Biden take advantage of his dad's political clout to build a career off that, whereas I, Congressman Matt Gaetz, would never do that with my state senator dad, who put me into
Right, exactly.
What's amazing is that they just don't care about their hypocrisy.
See, this is why people get turned off on politics. Matt Gaetz, a person who have benefited from having a father in a powerful position, and a father who came to his rescue in 2008 and saved him from getting a DUI. But he has the audacity to talk about Hunter Biden and what he did. See, the American people need to wake up and understand politicians don't care about morals. They only care about votes. Matt Gaetz have no right to be talking about Hunter Biden and his privilege that he have had by having his father, Joe Biden, as vice president and a senator for all these years, when Matt Gaetz has benefited from his father being a state senator for many years.